More than 1,000 Australians, including a record number of women, have been acknowledged in the 2022 Australia Day Honours.
Yeah, former New South Wales Rural Fire Service Commissioner, now Commissioner of Resilience New South Wales, Shane Fitzsimmons, has been acknowledged as an Officer of the Order of Australia for his remarkable leadership during the devastating 2019-2020 bushfire season. And Shane joins us now from Sydney. First off, Shane, congratulations. Fully deserved award and recognition, and we appreciate you spending some time with us this morning. What does receiving an AO mean to you? And how does the process, how do you process something like this?
Oh, good morning, Tristan. Good morning, Jess, and happy Australia Day. The honour is truly overwhelming. And yes, I accept it with immense pride and recognise the privilege, and to be in a list with so many remarkable Australians is really humbling. But in accepting this award, I pay absolute tribute to the remarkable men and women of the Rural Fire Service and the broader fire and emergency fraternity that have been my extended family for the vast majority of my life. And when I reflect on, and as you mentioned there, Tristan, the extraordinary events of the last 35 years, and in particular, the fire season of 2019-20 that was so damaging and destructive, I reflect on that with bittersweet. Obviously, I've got immense pride for the remarkable effort of all involved who tried to save and protect as much as they could, but also those that endured extraordinary suffering with loss and damage and destruction, and then the grief of losing loved ones. 26 lives were lost, including our 7 firefighters, our 4 volunteers, Jeff and Andrew, Sam and Cole, and then the 3 air crew, Ian, Paul and Rick. It will sit with me for the rest of my life, like so many other Australians. So yeah, mixed emotions today. Very proud, unashamedly very proud Australian, but I do so in acknowledgement of all my colleagues, all those that have supported me and helped me and that have been a part of my life for such a long time. I'm truly in awe of all that they do, and more importantly, the way that they do it.
Shane, we're so grateful for everything you did for us. Surely you deserve a cold beer in memory of those lost and also in celebration of your recent award.
Absolutely. And look, I'll have a few of those. And we do pay tribute only on the weekend, Jess. It's difficult to believe that Sunday was 2 years since that awful plane crash. Bomber 134 down near Cooma, a little place called Peakview, beautiful little place, out there trying to save and protect communities, crashed into the ground, killing all 3 on board. So, yeah, absolutely, it's appropriate and necessary to catch up with all those impacted and affected and all those that were involved in making a difference, and paying tribute and honouring and never forgetting the supreme sacrifice that many made, and too many have made over the decades.
Shane, you led New South Wales through the worst fire season in history. What are the qualities of a great leader?
Oh, Ange, I think there's so much to reflect on there. But for me, the half a dozen things that I think are critical is, number one, authenticity. We've got to keep things real. We've got to be the real you. Don't pretend to be somebody you're not. People see through it anyway. They don't like facades and they don't like poses. When we're dealing with difficult situations, to coin an old Aussie phrase, if you've got a dog poop sandwich, don't sprinkle fairy bread. Don't sprinkle hundreds of thousands on fairy bread and try and convince people it's on bread and convince people it's fairy bread. You know what I mean? So keep it real. I think humility is critical. Don't take yourself too seriously. Take what you're doing very seriously. And empathy is key. Understanding and trying to connect and relate to those impacted, affected, and involved is really important. Communicating and making decisions. Communicating the reasons behind those decisions, being really honest about what we know, what we don't know, what we're doing and why we're doing it, what we're not doing and why we can't do it, but most importantly, what do we want others to do? And the final thing that I would talk about is care. Leaders need to care. They need to care about their role, they need to care about their agency, they need to care about their teams, and of course, they need to care about their customer or the community. And if they don't care, why are they there? And if you don't care, I think people see through that, and I think it highlights very much in the decisions you make, the actions you take, the communication you deliver, the messages you deliver, and your connectedness with people. But the bottom line is, when things are tough, when things are difficult, our role as leaders is to build an environment of trust and confidence, and we build that through presence and authenticity, in my view.
Shane, we appreciate you so much and those who have given their lives to keep us safe, and we'll continue to do so. Congratulations again, and thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks, Tristan. Thanks, team. Really appreciate it. Happy Australia Day.